When a product is advertised heavily, sales will tend to grow very quickly, but eventually the market will reach saturation and the sales will slow. This type of growth is called limited growth. For the limited growth differential equation, if a quantity grows at a rate proportional to the distance from the maximum value m, it can be modeled with limited growth, which has the differential equation given here, y prime equals k times the quantity m minus y, where k is a constant and m is the maximum size of y. Let's take a look at an example. A manufacturer estimates that she can sell a maximum of 180,000 cell phones in a city. By advertising heavily, her total sales grow at a rate proportional to the distance below this upper limit. She enters a new market, and after 6 months, her total sales are 83,000 phones. Find a formula for the total sales in thousands of cell phones, t months after entering the market, and use this to estimate the total sales at the end of the first year. To save time, I've already set some of this up. Notice how m, the maximum, is equal to 180,000 here in our equation. And also I wrote y prime as dy dt. And then because she's entering a new market, we can assume y of 0 equals 0, meaning at time 0, she has sold 0 phones. And then after 6 months, she has sold 83,000 phones. So we know y of 6 equals 83. Notice how all of these are in thousands. So we'll begin by solving this differential equation here by using separation of variables. So for the first step, we'll multiply both sides of the equation by dt, which would give us this equation here. Now because we have dy on the left, we want this expression here, 180 minus y, also on the left. So if we divide both sides of the equation by this expression, it would give us this equation here. And now we can integrate both sides. Notice how I also wrote this as 1 divided by the quantity 180 minus y. To integrate the left side though, we do have to perform u substitution, where u would be equal to the denominator of 180 minus y. Notice that differential u would be negative 1 dy, or dy equals negative du. So if we write this in terms of u, we'd have the integral of 1 over u, but then dy is negative du, so we'd have negative du here. So the integral is going to be negative natural log absolute value u, or negative natural log absolute value of 180 minus y. We would have plus a constant, but we'll just go ahead and include that on the right side with the constant on the right. So on the right, we have the integral of k with respect to t, which would be kt, and then plus, we'll call it c sub 1, which again contains the constant from the left and from the right. Let's go ahead and multiply both sides of the equation by negative 1, which would give us natural log absolute value of 180 minus y equals, we'd have negative kt minus c sub 1. And now to solve this equation for y, we'll exponentiate both sides of the equation. So e raised to this quantity must equal e to this quantity here. Notice how the left would simplify nicely to the absolute value of 180 minus y, but because the right we have e raised to this power here, which would always be positive, we can drop the absolute value. So we'd have 180 minus y equals, on the right side, because we have a difference here, we can write this as e raised to the power of negative kt times e raised to the power of negative c sub 1. But if negative c sub 1 is a constant, then so is e to the power of negative c sub 1. So let's go ahead and let a be equal to e to the power of negative c sub 1. So now we can write this as 180 minus y equals a times e to the negative kt power. So now to solve this for y, we'll go ahead and subtract 180 on both sides. That would give us negative y equals a times e to the power of negative kt minus 180. And now we'll divide both sides by negative 1. So we have y, if we want y of t, equals negative a times e to the power of negative kt. This would be plus 180. So now we've made some progress. This would be the general solution to the differential equation. So now we'll use the initial conditions to find the particular solution and then make our estimate for the sales after 1 year or 12 months. So here are the two initial conditions that we had, and here's the equation that we just found for y of t. So using the initial condition y of 0 equals 0, when t is 0, the function value must be 0, which would give us this equation here. Notice when t is 0, this would be e to the 0, which we see here, and e to the 0 is just equal to 1. So this is really just 0 equals negative a plus 180. So move the a term to the left side, we have a equals 180. So if a equals 180, we can make that substitution for a here, giving us this equation. And now we still have to find k, so we'll use the second initial condition here to solve for k. So if y of 6 equals 83, this would give us the equation 83 equals negative 180 times e raised to the power of negative 6k, since t is 6, plus 180. Now we'll go and subtract 180 on both sides. That would give us negative 97 equals negative 180 times e to the power of negative 6k. Divide both sides by negative 180. That would give us 97 over 180 equals e to the power of negative 6k. Notice how here we had a negative divided by a negative, which made this positive. And now to solve for k, we'll take the natural log of both sides of the equation. We'll apply the power property of logarithms here, so we can move this exponent to the front, giving us natural log of 97 divided by 180 equals negative 6k. We'd have times natural log e, but that's equal to 1. So now we can divide both sides by negative 6 to solve for k. For this, we'll go to the calculator. Natural log 97 divided by 180, close parenthesis, divided by negative 6. This will be approximately 0.10304, which means our particular solution that we'll use to make our prediction for sales, we'll take this equation here and substitute the value of k that we just found. So now we know that y of t is equal to negative 180 times e raised to the power of negative 0.10304t plus 180. So this would be the particular solution to the differential equation. And now to make the prediction for the number of cell phones sold after 1 year, since t is in months, we want to find y of 12. So that'd be equal to negative 180 times e raised to the power of negative 0.10304 times 12 plus 180. And now we'll go back to the calculator. So y of 12 is approximately 127.727. Remember, this is the thousands of cell phones, so we could say this two ways. After 1 year, the estimated sales would be approximately 127.727,000 phones, or we could say 127,727 phones. Remember, y was in thousands, so we could express this two ways. I think in the homework, they want this answer here. I hope you found this helpful.